Thank you there, Rena, as we get you going here on this Tuesday afternoon, here on this 13th day of February, 888-MAD-DOG-6. We'll get your calls in here momentarily, and we'll do some things as far as that is concerned. So a very interesting couple days now. This is where baseball will have a little opportunity. I don't think anybody cares about the NBA, especially the All-Star game. The league, to their credit, knew that the All-Star game needed to be fixed. It was a disaster. So they try to put a little bit more ownage for the players and let them care more about the game, where maybe they can play a little defense and not allow 200 points, as we've seen in previous All-Star games the last 5-6 years. And so they are going to try to do their thing. And, you know, maybe Curry and LeBron, since they have their name in it and they pick the teams and all that. But the NBA right now is going through a period where it's a little shaky. Unless you're a diehard, I am not ready right now to get wrapped up in college basketball. I know the diehards out there care. I don't care about the quadrant system that they're worrying about, you know, with emphasis on road wins and, you know, what this win means and what that win means. You got to be a real diehard to get involved in that. Real diehard. It's probably on February 13th. You want to tell me on March 5th? You know, we break down who's in, who's not. I'll buy that. We'll sit there and we'll do that on March 5th, and we'll see if Western Kentucky deserves a bid and how many teams are going to take out of the Big 12 or the Big 10. But I cannot get into that. Unless you're Steve Torrey, I cannot get into that right now at all. I have tried. I sat there last night and watched a whole ton again. I just cannot, right at the moment, I cannot stomach the Winter Olympics. I know last night there was a lot of it was live coverage. And they had the skiing. I had it on for an hour, hour and a half. I tried to get wrapped up in it with Danny Hicks. I tried to get used. I saw a couple of the spills. I tried. I swear I tried, but I couldn't do it. After 40 minutes of that, an hour of that, I went to Breaking Bad. Saw a fourth season episode. I just could not under. I just couldn't do it. I'm being fair. I just, for whatever the reason, I was a little surprised. It seemed like the town was a little bit more enticing than I thought, Pyeongchang than I thought. And so from that standpoint, looked a little more enticing. I thought it was more godforsaken. Didn't appear to be that way. But I'm sorry. I just couldn't do it. Bottom line, I'm not into hockey at the moment. We're not there yet with hockey. 5-6 games to go. We'll take a look at the standings. It's going to be a wild chase in the Western Conference for those last few spots, because you got a lot of good teams. I mean, you're going to have 3 or 4 teams fighting for one spot with the points. We'll get to that when we get to the last 5-6 days of the regular season, which is still a good, you know, 6 weeks away at least. Season ends, I think, April 8th. So right now it's February 13th, so it's almost 2 months to go. So I got a long way to go there. I mean, so I figured baseball today would be a chance for the sport to go out there. You know, they got a lot of big stars showing up at camp. David Price did a press conference today. Yu Darvish was in Mesa today with the Cubs. He being announced. Obviously, you got the Yankees in the mix today with Boone. You got a lot of players still not signed yet, so that's interesting. You know, baseball is in the mix right now, and we'll see if people get wrapped up in it in the next. It's February, so it's not Game 7 of the World Series. It's February. But baseball right now, to me, has a little drama to it, especially the free agent scenario. Here's Tony in Dallas, and he's first up on a busy program today. Tony, good afternoon. How are you? Okay, pal? What's going on?
Christopher, you know, another, for a true baseball fan, another underlying issue here going into pitchers and catchers, as you just mentioned, is Scott Boras has a control of the baseball market. What Scott Boras has done, and if you look, and actually I was just reading up on him now while I was on hold, and by the way, you're on the page of Mark Townsend wrote an article for Yahoo Sports about Boras after the Darvish signing and maybe how that will start sending some dominoes, and there's a picture of you talking with Townsend. Anyway, here's what's interesting, Chris. I don't understand. You have players that are expressing frustration about the slow-moving market, yet it's the same players that belong to Boras, and Boras is getting them all overpaid contracts. So as a fan, or even as you guys, like you say, baseball has an opportunity here, but yet we're still waiting for what the NFL has. When the NFL has free agency, you have guys that are signing left and right. That's how the NFL will dominate you know, the headlines, even in the off season. Why is it that baseball always seems to be at the foot of Scott Boras, waiting for him to?
Well, that's because he's got, you hit it. He's a great agent. He's got a million players. The problem that you have right now, Tony, you summed it up. I mean, you have a big time agent who waiting for the one dumb owner, and usually he finds him, who's got you know, mediocre players based on, you know, stardom. I mean, Hosmer is a good player. He's not a great player yet. Yet Boras wants big time money, and he's not worth it. He's a good baseball player. He's not a great baseball player. 7 years, 140 is a perfect contract for Hosmer. Even too much, and Boras wants more because he thinks he's great. Arrieta's on the other side of the mountain. He had a year and a half where he was great. He was bad before that. He's not as good recently. He's 31 years of age. He's got a violent delivery. Buyer beware if you give him $200 million, and Boras seems to think that he's worth $200 million. That's a problem. Greg Holland had a terrible second half of the year. He had a 6-point-something ERA the last couple months of the season. Boras represents him. That's a holdup. Then you got J.D. Martinez, who is the poster boy of this, and Tony, you hit it right on the head. And J.D. Martinez is a guy that you know, does not play a lot of games. He's hurt a lot, who has been, you know, was a good player for Arizona. Don't get me wrong. He had 40-something homers, but he's a DH. He's not an outfielder. And Boras has convinced him and everybody else who believe in him that he's a $200 million player. You'd be an idiot if you gave him $200 million. So you have an issue with the agent who's got four big players who are not as good as the normal Boras client, and he wants the regular Boras money. That's a problem.
Yeah, and that's you're right. And J.D. Martinez doesn't want to be a DH. And, you know, in Boston, I thought Boston, the contract that they offered him, I think it's too much. But yet, and Boston has a very good defensive outfield, and he would be perfect DH, but he doesn't want a DH. One other point that I wanted to make, that you were talking about the Yankees, I think another underlying story there, Chris, is the fact that you have Manny Machado waiting in the weeds. And whether or not the Yankees do it this year or they trade, which would be an absolute sin for Baltimore to do it, they let him walk as a free agent. You know, the Yankees, if they're smart, they would trade Didi Gregorius and get high value for him, because they know that they're going to end up with Manny Machado, Chris. And that is going to be a crowded infield if you trade Didi now.
You can't trade Didi now. Good call, Tony, because you can't trade him now because you don't have a shortstop to play this year at the spot, because Machado is not coming here in 2018. And the Orioles are not trading him to you in July. So you can't trade Didi Gregorius right now because you need a shortstop and you're trying to win a championship this year. I mean, they are past the point of, you know, retooling and let's see what happens. We'll play it by year. They're going all in to win this year. That's why they got Stanton. And if you trade Didi Gregorius, they don't have a shortstop. And they have a young left side of the infield. So you can't do that. They will worry about what to do with Didi Gregorius if Machado is a guy that they want. And if he wants to or insists on playing third base, they'll worry about that at the time. You can make an argument that the Yankees will not be in the mix for both these big free agents, really all three of them, Donaldson included from Toronto. They don't need an outfielder, so that hurts Harper. Now, why would they need another infielder? If Torres is great and they got the kid Cedeno sitting there and they got Didi Gregorius, they may not need another infielder. That's another reason why this free agent thing has been a problem. New York, L.A., and Boston don't are quiet here. All trying to get under the cap. The Red Sox are being frugal. The Yankees trying to reset the luxury tax. So are the Dodgers. Those markets are not involved. That's one of the reasons why the sport has taken so much time here to figure itself out this winter. Sully in Baltimore is on Mad Dog Unleashed. Sully, good afternoon. How are you today?
Chris, thanks for taking my call. I want to keep the baseball going too, but I was listening to you talk about the Olympics, and I'm kind of with you on that. Although I got to tell you, the wife had on that pipe thing with Chloe Kim, the girl from California. She was absolutely tremendous.
Yeah, I try to get into it. I know she was, and I saw her on the Today Show today. She's 17 years of age. I could not watch it. I mean, I just couldn't do it. I mean, I'm not interested in backflips. You know what? You know what she is? She's an acrobat, is what she is. And it's almost like you're watching a circus with these guys. I mean, it's ballerinas on the ice and acrobats in the middle of the air. And I doing the backflips and doing this, doing that. I can't get into it. But I do know she's got a little charm. She's 17, and away she goes. I do understand that. Go ahead.
Work hard. Good kid. So baseball, totally with you. I'm so glad my Sox are staying pat. Forget J.D. Martinez. Let's roll the dice with the roster we got this year. Pressure's not on us like people think because there's not a whole lot of expectations with that pitching staff. You got Price coming back, hopefully. So he's gonna win another 10 games more than he probably did all of last year. Porcello can't have an awful year again, and I'll roll the dice with that outfield, and I would rather get ready for Machado or Bryce Harper coming down the pike in a year or so from now than take a Martinez and overpay any of these guys. I think Yu Darvish, that's too much money for Yu Darvish. These contracts need to settle out, in my opinion, and there's nobody worth a hoot spending a ton of money on in this particular.
They did overpay, Sully. Good call for Darvish, but the Cubs can afford it. He's their number two starter. The Cubs can afford it. That will be okay. I agree with you. And overall, I wouldn't have paid him that. But if it was a bad team, I would deal with it differently. For the Cubs, it's not as big a deal. They'll be okay. Here's T.P. King in San Antonio, Texas. T.P., good afternoon. How are you today? What do you have for me?
Well, here's what I have for you. I'm going to give you my over and under in the baseball so you can bet it and get back the money that I cost you when Atlanta won but didn't cover, followed by Jacksonville beating Buffalo but not covering. In my defense, however, Chris, I said...
Yeah, you told us about the teams that win. Pick the teams that win, TP, in the postseason. I tried that. Saints won, didn't cover. Patriots beat Jacksonville, didn't cover. Jacksonville beat Buffalo, didn't cover. Didn't work a lot in 2018. But you make
it right. But over the last 2 years, there's been 22 games. If you multiply 15% by 22, you get three games. Some years it's going to be one. Some years it's going to be zero. The last time I talked to you, I said, of the next four games, who do you like as an underdog? Because I won't make a bet unless I think the underdog can win. You thought about it, and you said, I like Philadelphia to beat Atlanta. I said, I agree with you. I bet that. I didn't bet Tennessee because I didn't think they could win. I didn't bet Jacksonville because I didn't think they could beat Pittsburgh. And then I loved New Orleans getting five. I don't want to go into how I pushed that, one of the worst pushes of the last 50 years of my, in the last 10 seconds.
27-22, that was a tough one. Yes, it
was. But here's another thing, Chris. This is here's the nuance.
What was it? 28-23 was the final score. They didn't kick They did not kick the extra point in that game, right?
Right, yeah. It ended on a push because a guy's diving. I don't know. He was diving.
You could have lost that game if he kicked the extra point. So look at it that way.
Correct. Now, here's a nuance that's very interesting. A lot of people are in-game bettors. Okay, so Atlanta's on the 4-yard line, fourth and goal. You can bet whether they'll score.
Yeah, I know that.
According to my theory, they have a 15% chance of scoring.
Is with four downs at the 4-yard line at the end of the game?
Fourth down.
Fourth down. Okay, gotcha.
Now, if they score, they win 16-15, and the points come into play. That's about a 15% chance based on statistics over the last 30 years. If they don't score, if Philly stops them and they win the game. And so you have an 85% chance Philly will stop them and win the game. They stop them and win the game. Also, when you can bet whether on the last drive if Brady will come down and score. Well, it's 38-33. If Brady comes down and score, they win 39-38. So you have an 85% chance that Philadelphia will stop that drive and win the game. They stop the drive and win the game. So there's a lot to it. It's pretty...
I can't get into these in-game bets. I know people get involved in that. How about baseball for a sec? Go ahead. Let me hear.
You had
some overs in baseball. Which ones you like? Let me hear.
Under 94 in the New York Yankees.
Under 94?
That's my bet.
Interesting. Good call. I haven't seen the over-unders yet in baseball. If I have, I haven't seen them recently. I don't know if Eddie got them. We'll do that maybe tomorrow. Again, there's so many free agents right now that it might be a little careful. They might be a little somewhat... They may not have him more released. 94 over number in the Yankees. Wow. They won 91 last year. That's tricky. That's a hard one. We continue update Dan Lang. Mad Dog.